moments ago inside the Oregon locker room. Coach Mike Bellotti and his players get fired up for the Big Ten. Michigan State arrives in the Northwest with a powerful running back, Cedric Irvin. Linebacker Peter Sermon, the Pac-10's leader in tackles last year, puts his reputation on the line against Irvin and the Big Ten. You are looking live at sold-out Autzen Stadium in Eugene, Oregon. The Oregon Ducks of the Pac-10 host the once-beaten Michigan State Spartans of the Big Ten. Good afternoon and welcome, everybody. I'm Brent Musburger. It's a very angry Michigan State team here today. They blew a 16-point lead in the first half a week ago against Colorado State. And coming up for them, Notre Dame and Michigan. Meanwhile, alongside me, one of the greatest Ducks of all time, Dan Fouts, wearing your alumni green, I see.
Well, Michigan State wears green, too, today. Brent, this used to be a two-quarterback system for the Oregon Ducks. It's one now. Akili Smith is the main man. Now for Michigan State, Bill Burke will take over. He'll be the guy.
The Ducks have won the flip, and they will go on offense. Booming kick, drives Fletcher deep out of the end zone. It'll come out on the 20-yard line. Reuben Drones, the JC transfer, the ballyhooed one, number 22, will be the featured running back behind this wide receiver group that has a dandy, a number 5, Damon Griffin, who returns after missing all of last season. The offensive line, can they hold up today? Aguirre over there, that tackle spot, must block Robert Smith. Keep an eye on that all game long. This is an undersized offensive line by Big Ten standards. Offset with Latimer, the offset back. Akili looks for him out in the flat, and he overthrows him. It'll be second and 10. Robert Smith and friends. Well, Colorado State put it to him late in East Lansing with that big touchdown by McDougal. So Robert, Mike Austin, he's the leading tackler. And the young corner, Ronaldo Hill, can he hold up today? Certainly no question about Amp Campbell. Here is Drones, no gain, and Michigan State immediately puts Oregon in third and 10. And let's see what they come up with here on third and 10. They offset the fullback to the left. Two wideouts, both out to Akili Smith's left. He's going to roll in that direction. Good strong arm, and he has got Tony Hartley for the first down.
And then he showed off that strong arm. Watch the block there, left side of the screen on Smith, as Drones helped out as well. All the time in the world to throw, and they like the way this guy throws outside of the pocket.
So they come up now to the 35-yard line for a first down. Conventional eye with a slot man, and they're going without a tight end. Movement by the defensive front first. And it was against the defense. There was movement on the left side of the defensive front as the tackle jumped in there and made contact. Saban asking for a clarification on that far sideline over there and gets it. But it'll be first and 5 for the Ducks now. This their opening drive of the football game. First and 5. 3 wideouts and a fullback in the formation for Smith. Looking option. Pitches back down to Drones. Drones has got a lane. Drones with the first down. Drones crosses midfield and hammers to the 45. The third first down. Drive began back on the 20. From the 45, Kelly fires hard, complete. Just inside the 40-yard line.
I'll tell you, watching Smith in practice, he reminds me of Tony Banks. Michigan State fans know exactly what I'm talking about. The great size, the downfield arm, and both are from San Diego.
Well, and if Akili has half the success in college that Tony had at East Lansing, Oregon's got something special there.
So we got a second down and 4. The freshman running back, Herman Ho-Ching, checks into that backfield. He's the tailback. He's supposed to be a whiz. Here he comes. Picks his way for a couple of yards and no more. The one back. Drones is offset just to Smith's right. Short drop. Fires. Drops.
Again, it's a quick three-step drop by Akili Smith. A good ball out here to Drones, and he just dropped it.
Two wides. Michigan State shows bump and run. Smith's going to look long. Going to fire. Got Hartley. Got it. First down inside the 20-yard line.
Little play action. Half roll again. Moving the pocket for Akili Smith. And it's a perfect throw. Hartley with the foot just getting down. He gets a little bit of a shove on the way out, but clearly inbounds. first down.
They got Newsom one-on-one on that coverage for a 20-yard gain, and now they're in the red zone. Oregon's first possession. Drones follows Young. Young couldn't clear it out, and Drones stepped back outside before Corrigan, who gets him outside, and that is Ho Ching. Let me check that.
Here's that fourth down conversion for Oregon. Excellent protection as they're, again, double-teaming Robert Smith. And one-on-one coverage on the outside.
Coaching again. No crease in the left side of that defensive front short of the first down.
Ho Ching is a true freshman, and he's getting his first taste of major college football, as is Reuben Drones. So you got two tailbacks. Oregon started the fall with six tailbacks. They've had a number of injuries. Kevin Parker, Darren Latimer. And so you got two guys never played at this level before, performing pretty good. This first
Damon Griffin, number five, goes off to the bottom of your screen. He's that wide man at number five. See him back off into that flanker spot. Very dangerous. Smith looks outside, fires, deflected, incomplete. Hartley, the intended receiver on that slant to the goal line. The punter is the holder, Josh Bidwell. Damn, the punter puts it down on its way. And Villegas, who won the kicking job the last week of practice, puts Oregon ahead on its first drive. Dan Katz handles the kicking off duties for the Oregon Ducks. Back deep, Irvin, the all-everything from the one-yard line, caught up for the Spartans. Cuts to the 20 and down at the 24. First and 10 now for the Spartans. Both hands off Irvin. Irvin cuts outside, breaks it 30, 35, 40, 45, and across midfield on his first carry of the game.
Watch the right side of the screen. Dietrich Moore gets smothered. Sermon doesn't keep his leverage on the outside. And then Fletcher on the safety blitz, number one, came up inside, and there's Irvin with a huge gain on his first carry.
Now he's put 28 yards on the board to start this one. First down and 10. Motion man, Scott for the Spartans. Burke, the left-handed throwers back. In trouble. Going down. And the Chili starting lineup with Bill Burke, Cedric Irvin, and Garrett Gould. He's the ISO fullback. And Plaxico Burris, number four. Could be a great one before he's finished. Jason Strayhorn, only two veterans come back, he and Mason. Strayhorn has to call the line blocking calls in the middle of that line. Second and 18 after the 8-yard loss on the sack by the Ducks. Here comes Irvin, swinging wide. This time he is down at the 46-yard line. Shotgun look for Burke and the Spartans. Three wideouts, inside shovel pass. Irvin breaks the first tackle, cuts inside, well short of the first down. Peter Sermon making his presence felt for the first time, number 44. There was the leading tackler a year ago in the Pac-10. He's a good one. So after a great-looking run on first down, the Spartans are stalled, largely because of an 8-yard loss on a sack. And this punt by Jarrett, a little bit too good into the end zone. It'll come out on the 20. So Oregon scores a field goal on its first drive, and the Spartans have to back to our producer, Bob Goodrich. Nice to have him down in the truck. First and 10 now for the Ducks, and Smith is back. Play fake. Drones the running back, going deep. Got one-on-one. One, Sermon got him. Damon Griffin.
Well, he missed all last year with a bad thumb. He was second team all Pac-10 a couple years back, and he is going to fill the void left by Pat Johnson.
The Ducks threaten immediately on first down. Fake swing, cut off. Robert Hunt pursuit, and he completes it anyhow.
An illustration of the strength and agility and mobility of Achilles Smith as he gets away from Robert. Oregon will run 8 to 10 different types of screens. That was going to be one.
Here's a man who can win those regular season non-conference games. They've done a great job here as he replaced Rich Brooks, who moved to the NFL. But Oregon's program has been on the rise ever since those days. And now after the penalty, first and 15. And Drone slides to the hole, slashes to the outside. Battles for the first down. Tough looking run by the young man from Anaheim, California, who came here from Merced College.
And he led the all junior colleges in the nation last year in rushing. This is great offense, though. The four wide receivers in the game, and the Ducks come with a little trap right up the middle. Now watch the receivers on the outside block. That's number five, Griffin. And that gave Drones a chance to get the first down.
Out, and now it is first down, just outside the red zone. Smith with time, wide open, got it back into
Blake Griffin's hands, his second catch of the day.
So Drones checks back in. He's the one back, number 22. Here he is now on second down and four for the Ducks.
And Drones looks whole, cuts back, very patient, good-looking run for a first down. That's a big-time run right there.
Griffin, Haynes, and Hartley are the three wideouts, so they continue to spread the field, even going in from inside the 10 with Akili Smith. Big, good-looking quarterback. Going to swing one. Here comes Drones, look at daylight. Drones crashes. Drones to the end zone. Touchdown, Oregon. He would not be denied.
Mike Bellotti and his offensive staff, they are as good as any team in the entire country at running screen passes. They especially like them in the red zone because you get so much man-to-man coverage down here.
Attempting to give the Ducks a 10-point cushion in the early going. He does just that. Kickoff going to sail out of bounds, and there's the penalty. You know, before the game, Mike Bellotti allowed us inside the locker room, and Reuben Drones took charge. But if you're going to talk the talk, you better walk the walk, baby. And here he comes, Dan.
And he gets a real fine block by his wide receiver, Tony Hartley, number 10 right there. That gave him the crease. But again, the desire to dive across the end zone.
Here they're down by 10. Burke's going to throw on first down. Out to the left side, into the hands of Scott for a first down. He stepped out for an 11-yard gain at the 46-yard line. That is Bowman. Now, Bowman's an interesting story. That corner over there, number 17, is only 5'8". And you would expect the taller Scott and Burris to go to work against him before the day's over, Dan.
Scott goes 6'1", but it's Burris who goes 6'6", that will really challenge Bowman and the entire secondary. They want to throw the ball more, and they want to get the ball down the field to these tall receivers.
Here comes Irvin, picking his way to midfield. Here's his second down now. Shotgun look from the Spartans. Going to try that inside. Straight handoff this time to Irvin, being the workhorse. He is short of the first down by a couple of yards.
32. This should be advantage Spartans. When you've got a running back like Irvin, you can show the ISO play. You can come up throwing off of it. You can do so many things in 3rd and 2. Here is 33. Picks his way. Going to be close. He may be just short.
Got a yard to go. They'll line Irvin up deep. They'll motion Scott and move that tight end. They'll show muscle on the left side now for Burke. Remember, this is 4th down. Here comes 33. Long handoff. Irvin's not going to get it. Oregon football.
And for the left side of the screen, you'll see Fletcher force Irvin back, and then there's Shuvron for the huge play on 4th down.
The Ducks will send Herman Ho-Ching into the tailback, and they'll run him on 1st down. Cutback. And down he goes.
Let's talk about this Oregon Duck defense. You know, they were somewhat suspect last year, but they brought in a new defensive coordinator, and Bob Foster said, forget statistics. These are the things that he wants his players to do. If you play hard and you play every minute of every down, the statistics will come your way.
2nd down and 10 now, and Akili pulls it out, goes to that left as he has been. Oh, wide open over here is Griffin. His 3rd reception, they were way too soft on a major league receiver like that.
18 yards more for Griffin. 3 receptions now for 73 yards. Missed all of last season because of torn thumb ligaments. 1st down and 10. Duck stock still more.
And here's Ho-Ching. He's a true freshman, folks. So Drones replaces him now. They alternate at the tails. We look at a 2nd down and 7. You've got to like this quarterback here. This is an underrated quarterback that we're watching, and he worked hard in the offseason. Shows option. Big fella keeps it. 25, 20. Smith out of bounds.
Watch the strength he has here with the straight arm to pull away from Sori Kanoe. And if Drones could have got to the inside and given him a block right here on Marshall, he might have scored.
He is showing why the coaches had confidence in him as a freshman as he alternates with the JC transfer. Drones, he's the one back. And Smith wasn't too sure, and I'm not sure that Ho-Ching was on that play.
Oregon has a very diverse offense. They have 3 wides, 4 wides, 2 tight ends, and the reason they do that is because they don't feel that they're physical enough to just line up and beat you with the same plays every week. Plus, it gives the kids something to look forward to in those very long offensive meetings. What new plays are we going to run this
now? Smith saw something with the defense, and he wants to check it over with the coaches. When you come here, I was impressed with the practice. The facility has been upgraded so much, but there was a confidence with the fans in this town.
Brent, you were talking about the fact that Akili Smith shows much better poise as a quarterback. And one of the reasons is because his offensive coordinator, Jeff Tedford, brought some checkers in the offseason. And he set them up like the ball players would be. Fullback, halfback, all of the players. And then Akili would have to make the line calls from that. He would also have to set up any checkoff systems. And he said he got real good at that kind of checkers.
This is a 2nd and 7 for the Ducks. And Smith rolls right wide open. Touchdown, Oregon! Chris Young, the fullback. They practiced that play. The fullback is not a big weapon.
Perfect defense for Oregon because the blitz is going to come right up the middle here, and the fullback sneaks out into the flat. Good job by the tailback picking up the blitz. And that's just a wide open fullback for the easy score. But again, we're seeing a lot of different plays by Oregon.
Nick Saban is wondering, where did all these Ducks come from? I mean, he's got to feel like George Custer right now. This is unbelievable. They've handled the ball 3 times. They've stuck in 2 touchdowns and a field goal. And we got Amp Campbell down on the ground again. He injured his knee last week against Colorado State. Perfect.
I think if we play better defense, if we're better at the line of scrimmage, a better first down defense, primarily run defense, if we can show that trait, if we can accomplish that goal, that'll be the one thing I want to take into the rest of our season. And win or lose, I know that'll help us. If the other thing is that we have stepped up or been able to continue our efficiency on offense in terms of getting the ball in zone, I don't care about yards, I don't care about first downs, I care about points.
I'll give you a way tonight at a saloon to win a little trivia. Ask them which teams in the Pac-10 over the last 4 years have won the most games. I will guarantee you they will not say Oregon, but it is Oregon and Washington with 31 victories apiece. This school has come alive out here, and Michigan State certainly knows now, with Haygood having replaced Irvin as a deep man. They put him in the hands of Scott from the 6-yard line, and Gary Scott to the 24-yard line.
It's a physical game right now, Brent. I'll tell you, Cedric Irvin twisted his knee. No big problem, no big concern. But for Amp Campbell behind me, it's a severe shoulder stinger. The medical staff is working with him right now. It remains to be seen what his eventual condition will be.
So the backup, he's quite a story. Injured a year ago, transferred from Rhode Island, hasn't played much over the last few years. He now must carry the load. His first carry into the middle, he is tripped up.
He wants to get Clemens in the game more and have an ideal situation with, as they had last year with Mark Renaud and Irvin.
So Burke forced to play catch up. Goes deep middle. Scott diving catch. A beauty to the Oregon 40-yard line.
When you run the ball well, you get a little play action. Nobody near the quarterback. And this is his best throw of the season.
Burris and Scott, they'll be the big men, as now the Michigan State Spartans are forced into a catch-up mode like Colorado State a week ago. Fake handoff, Clemens. Now Burke going to throw back up. No, down he goes as the defender, number 38, Terry Miller, undersized defensive end out of Vancouver, Washington, closed in on him. Dan, what were the keys of the first quarter?
Well, after the play action here, the screen pass to Reuben Thrones as he powers his way into the end zone. And then defensively for Oregon, on a 4th down, an 8-yard loss here for Cedric Irvin and maybe a twisted knee. That led to this play, the easy toss to the fullback, Chris Young, for the score.
And it is 2nd and 20 at midfield.
This is unusual in the middle of a series to bring in a new quarterback. I know it's the start of the second quarter, but it is the middle of this series.
He's a young man, he's confident, and wrapped up. You know, here's what Van Dyke had to say when we asked him, what's it going to be like when he steps inside that huddle with those veterans? Here's what he had to say.
You know, get everybody quiet first, and, you know, call the play. And I'd say, you know, you guys block, I'll pass. Cedric, you run. Paxco, you catch it, we'll be just fine. And, you know, get out of there, right, and do our thing.
I think he may have talked too much in the huddle that first time.
Delay a game call.
Just say it quicker, Ryan, and you'll be fine, young man.
Big, good-looking young player throws it deep. Picked off at the 30-yard line. Intercepted by Bowman. And the 5-foot, 8-inch diminutive one is inside the 35-yard line.
And this is an easy pick for Bowman. Protection is there. The ball is just way underthrown to Scott. And Bowman brings it back a long way. But again, I got to go back to changing the quarterback in the middle of a series. I know they had a timeout there at the end of the first quarter. But that is a very difficult situation.
Not Oregon yet. Short field to work with. They're inside the bounce zone. We'll tell you about that in a second. Keeley fires high, incomplete.
I just think that it's so difficult at times to score inside the 20 because teams are playing zone and changing up defenses. Take those plays that you run in the 20-yard line, that red zone, and then bring it out to the 40. And I think that's what Oregon just did that time. They went up deep to their tight end down the sidelines. If they were to run that in the red zone, the regular red zone, they may not have as much room to execute.
Second down and 10. Ball at the Spartans 35-yard line. There's that option look again, and pitch drones. Big Alex. So Dan Fouts, once one of the all-time passing leaders here at Oregon. I guess how times have changed with Musgrave and now Akili.
Don't forget Danny O'Neill.
Yeah,
that's some good ones. Love to throw the ball here at Oregon.
Here's the third down and short. Drone stopped. Best defensive play of the game. So they're going to give Viegas a chance here on a longer field goal. It will be a 44-yard field goal. On its way. Got it. Four possessions, two touchdowns, and two field goals. And it was a turnover as the freshman quarterback, Van Dyke, tries to go deep. And Bowman picks it off. And that set up the field goal. Timeout in Eugene. 20 in the Spartans looking for something to build on. Katz booms one. It'll come out of the 20. Well, let's take you back to 1970, folks.
We're in number 11. Not so sure they had colored television in those days.
This is my buddy, Mr. Fouts. First pass in Portland. He's got Bobby Newland against Cal. Oh, baby, what happened on that play, my friend?
He told me that he lost it in the light. I told him.
There you are.
He could have caught it with the blindfold. This is Ahmad Rashad on the right and Tom Graham on the left. Some of the all-time Ducks, but that ball was right there. How did he drop it?
You've never let him forget it either. That's our Marriott moment, folks, and we love showing it to you. Van Dyke still in after throwing the interception. He opens the series here, and that looks like Cedric Irvin. So let's go back in slow motion now. Fouts claims the ball was right on the money here.
Well, if you look right here, watch it come down right there. Yeah, well, it's a little bit over his outside shoulder. But, you know, Bob Newlin went on to have a great career with the New Orleans Saints.
Yes,
so
he
overcame that one setback.
Second down and 7 now. Short drop. Van Dyke snaps it off to the tight end. And that is a first down for the Spartans as Brad Renko, who caught a touchdown pass last week, makes the first down. Van Dyke looked pretty good rolling back on that, was confident. The Spartans have to be thinking one at a time. Just come on down. Lots of time to go in this game. Scott's your motion receiver. Irvin back in. That's positive. Big hole in the middle. And Cedric pounds out to the 43-yard line.
And let Cedric Irvin use his great vision and ability to cut. Oh, that's a big hole there. There's the cut. And he's close to a first down, but that's Big Ten. Flint's already broken a number of arm tackles in this ball game.
You know, got him in second down and short. Van Dyke with that option look. He was a pretty good runner at Marshall. First down, close to midfield. Oh, he's down. Van Dyke is down right now.
Well, he's in behind Sean Mason here. Watch, he lowers that left shoulder and takes a direct hit on it. I would suspect a dislocation.
So here's Bill Burke from Warren, Ohio. The junior returns. Deep drop comes to the middle. Scott, no incomplete.
Good job Justin by the weak Wilcox. Safety. Yes, Justin Wilcox, number 19, the son of the great 49er linebacker Dave Wilcox and brother of Josh, the tight end who used to play here at Oregon.
Irvin. Irvin's got an alley. Cut back right at the down mark. Wilcox again. His brother made the New Orleans Saints, made their final roster. They will open in St. Louis against Dick Vermeil's Rams tomorrow. We got the first down, Dan. Irvin did on that run. They go to three wideouts, and Lloyd Clemons checks into the backfield, and Clemons powers ahead. Threatening with still 10:43 to go in the first half of this football game. Second down and two. The defense holds. This will be third and short, and it is time for our Aflac trivia quiz. John Robinson, George Seifert, and Bruce Snyder have in common. Think about that now. John no longer at USC. Seifert, of course, doing television work. Bruce is down at Arizona State. Big one against Washington tonight. Think about those three fellas now. Well, there's the messy numbers. Oregon, if you're a Michigan State fan, it's messy. If you're an Oregon fan, you're saying, come on, lads, keep it going. Here's your third down and short now. And Burke down the sideline, got one-on-one. Caught as he knows he's out of bounds. Comes fourth and two. Second fourth down gamble of the day. Burke throws incomplete. Oregon takes over.
Everything has worked. I mean, when you look at drones getting in the end zone and Young, two guys that didn't even play for Oregon last year, and that's what's been most impressive. We knew the passing game to the wide receivers would be good, but drones running the ball well. Ho Ching is running it well, and the fullbacks in the end zone.
Kelly Smith looks like he's going to be a good one, a real good one. Play fake, got time, coming right side. Threw a little bit behind Donald Haynes that time. Here's second down and 10. Smith rolling right. Now fires, almost intercepted. He threw the ball low. And of course the sophomore, Ronaldo Hill, is over at the right side. Here's your third down and 10 against this secondary. Smith over middle, caught, first down. Great grab by number 81, Jed Weaver out of Redmond, Oregon.
What the quarterback sees on this play is he sees number 9, Eric Morris, with his back to the quarterback. And so this allows Smith to throw the ball right over his head, right into the tight end. And that's a heck of a grab by Weaver, as he knows he's got number 9 beat, but who's behind him? There's Marshall coming up with the hit.
First and 10 after the 22-yard gain. And Smith, too much time, receiver covered, scampers left, he's fast. Outruns two defensive linemen and picked up 11 yards. The NFL scouts better get up here and start taking a look at this big fella. He is starting to come along. Achille, now with that three-step drop, fires that sideline pass, and it's a beauty. 250 yards, ladies and gentlemen. They've scored at least a field goal on every drive inside the 25. Here's the hand. Ho Ching got the trail, and he is down. One back is Ho Ching. Three wides and a tight end this formation, and Smith changes up the play. Short drop, first option is covered. Gonna keep it, gonna try to cut back. Got trouble, now fires, got him! Touchdown, Oregon! Oh my, Achille Smith may be the real deal as Bobby Nero pulls it in.
This is as good a play a quarterback will ever make as he finds Nero in the back of the end. Was in all kinds of problems there, and what a great throw as he was running left at the last minute and rifled it over the middle.
This is a remarkable performance by our quarterback. There were doubts about his ability to do this and lead this team. The extra point is good.
And this is Bobby Nero. He's not the primary receiver, but what he does is he runs along the back of the end zone and finds the open area. It was supposed to be out here to the right. This is the athletic ability that Smith was talking about. Look at that throw. Unbelievable throw.
Now we want to hear the young man in his own words. Here's Achille Smith on the scramble when he takes off for the run.
When a protection breakdown, I usually roll out the pocket and look for a wide open receiver. If nobody's open, then I'm looking to make a move and get as much as I can and try to stay away from a negative play.
The young man steps right up there. He talks very well. You can understand him. There he is with the headphones on the sides, and he is a horse. I think he's even bigger than 6'3" when I watched him on a practice field the other day. I came away saying, oh my.
And for a guy with real long legs, he has very quick feet. A good combination.
At the goal line. Scott going to bring it out. Twists his way to the 29-yard line. And here comes Mr. Burke. And I would say the Spartans and their coaching staff have to be shell-shocked by what has happened. As Urban trying to string this play out is pushed out of bounds.
But, you know, he told me yesterday it was Bowman, and he proved to me with the interception that I'm going to call Bowman.
Whatever you want. Second down and 6 now for the Spartans. There's a handoff. Now, remember our trivia question? We asked you about 3 coaches. What do they have in common? George Seifert, Bruce Snyder, and John Robinson. Now, here is the answer to your Aflac trivia. Take over here, Mr. Fouts.
Yeah, they were all on the Oregon coaching staff from 67 to 71. Of course, I was a member of the ball club from 69 to 72. You think we would have won more games with those great coaches?
They told me it was the quarterback. No, I'm just kidding, partner. Just kidding. Third down and 4. Short drop. Burke fires high. Incomplete that time. Does get this one off. And here's Fletcher running toward the sideline. He'll let it take a bounce, and it does for Michigan State before it goes out at the 11-yard line. We'll take a break. 7:18 to go in the first half.
It's a fact that we're one of the top 20 places in America to study journalism. We checked it 5 times. We also rank 11th in the world for our impact on the field of psychology. So if you feel the sudden desire to be a duck, we'll understand.
Senior quarterback Akili Smith out of San Diego has done everything. He's thrown 3 touchdown passes on the game. Overall, he's passed for 177. He has also rushed for 28 yards. That means that Akili Smith has 205 yards of total offense here in the first half. And back to work come the Ducks. Some 90 yards away. Drones battles in that hole. Finally stood up at the 14. And no one is prouder of Akili than his father right here, Ray Smith. It must be great having a son like that. You're watching him from the sideline, huh?
Come on. You have good seats, too, right down in the front row. You know, as long as I've watched football games, I don't think I've seen a better throw than what Smith just made to Bobby Nero in the back of the end zone. That was an incredible play.
You know, that's Nero's first reception in college ball. How about that, huh, for a touchdown? Here's a second down now and 6 coming up. Ball on the 15-yard line. And Drones, huge hole, cuts left, 30. 35, foot race, 45. The Spartans with the angle.
And Michigan State had Oregon in terrible field position. And in 2 plays, they're already out to midfield. Right up the middle on the draw play. Austin misses. And then the moves of Drones as he gets help from his wide receiver again.
And Drones with 81 yards rushing in his first game. First down. Here's Akili. Going deep, wide open. Got him. Touchdown, Tony Hartley. That's mile 4.
He is turning this outfit into a bunch of killer ducks.
Let the Heisman wash begin in Eugene. 6 possessions, 4 touchdown passes, and 2 field goals. Adds an extra point. A stunned Spartan team here today.
Pass protection has been excellent all day long for Akili Smith. He gets to really air this one out. And watch the effort by Tony Hartley, as he's not going to be denied. Newsom closes, but not fast enough.
And you thought Dan Fouts was the greatest quarterback in Oregon history. Ha, ha, ha. We'll be right back. Fouts just asked me if this reminded me of the Aloha Bowl. And I say no, because remember the Spartans fumbled the ball away 5 times in that game. They turned it over. Here is simply Oregon getting the job done. And Scott brings it out. Runs hard out to the 27. So Leroy McFadden and Lloyd Clemons check on in. And that's Clemons. As as Burke rolls off to the left and fires incomplete.
The temperature, Brent, has begun to escalate here. And I'll tell you what, when you're the defense like Michigan State, you've got to get off for a while. They haven't had much of a breather in the first half.
Second down and 10. Trailing 34 to nothing. And pounding away with Lloyd Clemens, the senior from Detroit. Third down and 2 for the Spartans. There's still over 5 minutes to go in the first half, and they're down by 34. Slips down at the 34-yard line. Clemens. Four touchdown passes, two field goals. Jarrett bangs one. Oh, he drives Fletcher back inside the 10-yard line. Penalty flag is down. There's an illegal block.
Jason Moss in the game at quarterback at some point here in the second quarter. I think a 34-point lead.
Illegal block in the back on the return. Half the distance from the spot of the foul. First down.
4-point lead might be a good enough cushion for Moss, although he doesn't need it. He threw for over 1,000 yards last year as he split time with Achille Smith.
Now, he had a back that was bothering him. You and I were out of practice. He didn't play. He didn't take any reps the other day. And here is Jason trotting on out to the field. And Darian Latimer checks in as his running back. And Moss is going to put it up on first down. Incomplete. In and out of Griffin. Griffin was turning around on the pass.
Unbelievable.
It doesn't get any better than that. You know, they wanted 90% inside the red zone. Well, when you go out to the 40-yard line, it gives you a little bit more room. And with the arm strength of Achille Smith and the speed of these receivers, doesn't get any better than 5-5.
Moss eyes the defense now. Second down and 10. Latimer keeps going. Finally down at the 10-yard line. Gains a couple of yards.
Moss taking a look. Three wide outs. One running back movement by the defensive tackle who jumped across.
Head ball. Offsides.
And again for the Spartans, the road ahead's tough. Notre Dame at home next week. Then it's Michigan. Moss going to be sacked inside the 10-yard line. Desmond Thomas, number 66.
And we will finally see the punter. They got one of the best in the country out here in Oregon. Name is Josh Bidwell. Here's Scott. And for the Ducks, they only needed half a game.
From the 45, crosses midfield, alley in the middle, and down at the 38-yard line.
I'd throw it to Burris and let him hip-hop in.
Burke, looking outside, drops it off to Scott. Fumble! I believe the Spartans, let's see what happened right there.
I'm not sure who punches this one loose from Scott, but he has a nice game working here. His ball was kicked out of his hand by Robinson Randall.
Second down and 7. Shotgun Spartans. Backs are out. That's a first down to Burris.
Ball is at the 26-yard line.
Steps out of the way. Gets a nice block. Fires incomplete. Pressure. Got one-on-one, and they turn back with Burris against the defensive back, Eric Edwards.
Looks pressure. They had one-on-one. And remember, this is Bob Foster's defense.
He returned to active coaching. He was once Mike Bellotti's head coach. As Michigan State against Bob Foster's defense is 0-for-5 on third down. Here is their sixth attempt. No blitz package. Goes, fires corner, knocked away by Edwards. Beautiful play by the corner that time.
Watch this coverage. Edwards is a three-year letter winner. This is perfect coverage as he looks back for the ball, squeezes the receiver to the sideline, and then makes a play on the ball.
Four-man rush. Burke steps up, gets hit on a release, fires it. Short of the first down. Oregon football.
Big difference in the sophistication of these two passing offenses today.
And with that 34-point lead, Coach Bellotti's going to simply take a knee and run the clock out. What happened to Moss on that when he went down?
Well, you know, he has a disc problem in his lower back. He might have just jarred it just a little bit that time.
Yeah, because it didn't look like anybody rushed him or anything. It did. He just went down, but you could see him wince.
Yeah, he's in pain right now. Yeah, there he goes with the left hand right to the back.
and he flips it on over to the referee and heads on into the locker room.
And the Ducks take a 34-0 lead into the locker room at intermission.
It was the Kelly Smith show in the first half. Four touchdown passes. His running back, then firing to his fullback, and then hanging a rope under enormous pressure to his young wide receiver, and he wasn't finished as he went 53 yards. Overall, 12 of 18, 229 yards, and four touchdowns. Defensively, they answered every call, stopping Michigan State three times on fourth down, including right there.
And that's a defense that gave up 185 yards on the ground per game last year.
Look at our Morgan Stanley, Dean Witter, first half statistics. Not only did they stop him three times on fourth down, look at the Spartans. Six misses on third.
Granny's satisfied with the points that he's got, but he's issued an ultimatum to his defense. He told these guys that the first series on defense was a chance for his defense to make a point. And he said, I want to see that point. He's looking for them to hold him three and out and send the Spartans off to the sidelines.
The kickoff in the air from 2 yards deep. Scott elects to bring it on out for the Spartans. And a solid return to the 26-yard line.
Well, Brent, this kind of goes back to what we talked about. The Oregon offense is so diverse and has so many great athletes. Saban was very concerned with the skilled people, the explosion plays of Oregon, the big plays, and it's been all big plays in that first half.
So they go to a one back with two wideouts and a couple of tight ends, and McFadden has stopped, spins, loses a yard, down he goes. There's that defense again with Chouvrant, number 34. And weaving a shutout right now against the team that leaked all kinds of points last year. Fires complete to Scott, and he's pounded at the 29-yard line by 5 foot, 8-inch Rashad Bowman out of Phoenix. Bowman shows bump and run. Burke rolls right, fires high, incomplete. And getting a hand on the football that time was a defender who dropped back into that passing zone for the Ducks. And that was Garrett Sable, number 35. A little low. Fletcher's going to scoop it at the 25. Look for a block. Cut up the middle. 30-yard line. Spin and down. Still battling his way, actually, to the 32-yard line.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I always thought that Dan Fouts had given the most to his alma mater. Then I met this gentleman here, Philip Knight, the CEO of Nike. Philip, nice to have you with us. I know how important this school has been to your background.
Thanks very much, Brent. It's great to be here on this day.
Yeah, you know, Fouts is the one who told us that this quarterback could play. He was right all along.
Keely Smith, we've been saying he's a Heisman Trophy candidate, and he's looking like it today, isn't he?
And the problem you're going to have, Phil, is I'm going to represent him against you next year when he's an NFL pro.
Now, you stick right here. Bundle, huh? Yeah, you stick right here. We're going to watch a couple plays. Phil, I think the story is worth telling all over again about the track coach and how Nike got founded here at Oregon.
Yeah,
give us
right
a little brief.
It was
that.
Right on Hayward Field, about 2 miles from here. Bill Bowerman, my old track coach, and I decided to start a shoe company, and that was 26 years ago, and it's worked pretty well.
Now, why did you decide to start a shoe company? There were other shoes there.
The ideas came from Bowerman, who was a great track coach and a great innovator, and he just thought there was a better way to make shoes. He thought that you could make better shoes, and better shoes would help people run faster.
Well, Dan, here is a second down now, and Achille rolling right again. He's got wide receivers open, going deep, incomplete. And Dan, your feeling about Achille Smith, I think you're surprised about his confidence that we've seen here today.
Totally different player than he was last year. Last year, he made a lot of mistakes because he wasn't as confident, wasn't as comfortable with the offense. But the time he put in the offseason really paid off. And you're seeing a guy that is, you know, you always talk about going to the next level. Well, Achille Smith is now at that next level. He's just not a guy hoping to have success. He's having wonderful success in a very big ballgame.
Well, let's take a look down here at the third down play. Again, I'm with Dan Fouts. Phil Knight, CEO of Nike. Big Oregon booster and an alum. As Achille pulls out, fires wide open, and battles for the first down. Griffin lost the football. Went back after it over there on that far sideline. And you can take a look at this for us, Dan.
Now, the key on a short pass like this is timing. And what both between the quarterback and the receiver, the quick drop by Smith, and he has this ball out there. Look how far off the defensive back is. He cannot come up and make a play before Griffin makes the first down.
You know, one thing, Phil, the facility here is so much better than when you were in school, even
sure
when Dan
was
in school.
That they played football over at Hayward Field, 22,000 fans back when I was in school, so it's gotten a lot better, you bet.
Here's a first down now for the Ducks. And Achille buys that time, fires just inside the 45-yard line, and the ball was on the carpet, so it is incomplete. Phil, somebody told me that Nike would also like to see a green helmet worn by the Ducks. Now give me an indication as to why. Obviously, there's a merchandising factor here. You like the color. What's the situation?
We don't sell helmets. I think you got some misinformation, Brent.
Damn, somebody told me it was Nike wanted the green.
Well, I mean, you see the swoosh on everything else around here. And I was in the ball club when the Oregon Ducks last wore the green helmets. I kind of like them.
Second down now. Fires, puts it back into Griffin's hands, and he crosses midfield as he comes out to the far side. So here are our storylines from the top of this game. And again, we expected this to be a close Big Ten, Pac-10 tussle, but it was Oregon behind Achille Smith. Look at that, 248 passing yards. And Peter Sermon, the linebacker we told you about, led the Pac-10 a year ago with six tackles. They've held Irvin to 62 yards. And we have gone through a couple of Michigan State quarterbacks. Burke, 6 of 14 for 72 yards. And, of course, Van Dyke out with that injured shoulder. First down now for the Ducks as they move to the 46-yard line. And Drones is jumped by Robert Smith, number 91. Phil, how many schools does Nike contribute to the athletic fund? How many schools have you signed up now? We see the swoosh all over campuses.
Well, that we work with a lot of different colleges, that some in football, some in basketball, some in track, so they're not all school deals. We only have about 12 all school deals, and probably we have 75 different programs across the country.
And it is so important, Dan, as I have said, to these college athletic programs to get this money from the shoe companies, not just Nike, but certainly they're our largest representative in this country. And here is Drones now. Slants off left, got a hole, slashes, and keeps on going. There's a penalty flag thrown down. He did reach the first down marker.
Really good vision and speed to get to the outside, but what impresses you is how you finish off the run. A couple of times now we've seen Drone as tacklers are hanging on him, having the strength to go forward and get close to the first down.
Has Tiger Woods improved your golf game at all, fellow?
Actually, I have improved since we signed Tiger Woods, but I really can't give him credit. An improvement means from about 100 to 90.
I understand. You know, you're hanging around with my old buddy Peter Jacobson. Yeah. I knew you needed a real instructor to help you out to make you a golfer. Well, you had to get Tiger in there.
Peter's tried, but it takes a lot of work.
I thought that was Jake Trout.
Peter, nice to see you another day. Phil, thanks for dropping
by. Great to be here. Thanks
oh, yeah. It's a great day for Ducks, you and Fouts and Jacobs.
The weather is like this all the time out here. Thanks a lot.
All right, Phil. Phil Knight, the CEO of Nike. First down for his Oregon Ducks. Trout, Smith throws deep left side. Incomplete.
You know, one thing you don't know about Phil Knight is that he personally donated a bunch of money to the University of Oregon for the library. It is now called the Knight Library, K-N-I-G-H-T. You know,
I knew that he was a big contributor up here and very important to a lot of programs, I'll tell you that.
I still don't know where the library is, but I know that his name is on it.
I wasn't going to bring that up with you. Second down and 10. There's that draw play, and Ho Chang going to go down for a big loss.
The concern, Brent, was about the stinger and the numbness and the tinging that he had in his arm. As they went through the x-rays, which they have not been able to get back definitively, that numbness went away. So he's returned back here after that hit. He had to go to the hospital. They checked it out. The numbness has gone away. That's good news. The doctors say they'll reevaluate tomorrow.
Yeah, he was in obvious pain after throwing his shoulder and the receiver on that touchdown. And there's Achille. He's going to be wrapped up at the 45-yard line. So Bidwell punting again, and again he is one of the better punters out here on the West Coast. Let's see where he drops this one inside the 20-yard line. Oh, great hang time. Oh, what a good-looking punt. If that comes up short of the end zone, but it did not. There's some scouts out here putting a stopwatch on number 40. That young man can hang a football. We're going to take a timeout. It's still all Oregon and Eugene. Dan, any bright spots for Michigan State?
Well, number six. This is Corey Sanu's 31st consecutive start in the secondary. Had 108 tackles last week, and he has been the big hitter for Michigan State so far today. Had a lot of opportunities, too, the way Oregon's been running through that front line.
Well, here's Burke off a fake, now rolling. Fires to the sideline, incomplete, and a penalty flag is down.
Is he a passer?
Yeah.
And, you know, Pat Flood, our official for the day, making the call right there. And he's very sensitive to these quarterbacks getting a shot like that. And that's a good call because that ball was clearly out of Burke's hands.
First down and 10. And Burke slips. They show a slot right. Throw in underneath the Burris. And Burris down at the 34-yard line.
Look who's waiting to come in the game. He's two touchdown passes away from the Oregon record held by Danny O'Neill for a single game.
This now is their eighth. Here is a third and 10 for Burke. Rolling. Not going to get it this way. You got to throw that ball 10 yards.
Seen different with Foster, what he's done with these kids defensively here today.
Well, they're much more aggressive. It's a simpler defense that Oregon's running.
Fletcher going to pick this one out of bounds. This is dangerous. Down on the 20-yard line.
Nick Saban is a big fan of motivational books. He's read a lot of things that are in that motivational vein. So this year, he brought out this book, The Road Less Traveled. Many of us have read it. He told his team to read it. You want to hear what the first page of the first chapter says? Life is difficult.
Especially when you're trailing by 34 in the second half, my friend. As Achilles Smith has to throw that one away. There was a receiver over there, however. And here comes Achilles. Too long, Tony Hartley. And a penalty flag has been thrown.
Pass interference on the defense. It's a spot foul. Results in about a 15-yard penalty. Automatic first down.
Slot formation off to the right. And this is Drones, the JC running back on first down. So Reuben Drones right at the century mark. He has rushed for 100 yards with 12 carries in his first game. He's got it on the option. And he's got more. Beautiful run. Appeared to be wrapped up. Slipped through and picked up another Oregon first down.
That 9-yarder wasn't bad.
That's how you can always tell over there. The big fella's getting down in that pit now to go at it. Run away from him, and you got to be impressed with Drones. They've got themselves a find. They lost the Pac-10's leading rusher, McCullough, moved on to the NFL. He was cut by a couple of teams already, but they have signed the JC transfer.
And I keep going back to that scene in the locker room before the game when this JC transfer is firing up his brand new teammates.
Gonna throw left, like what he saw. Got it complete. Picked up Tony Hartley, the junior from Los Alamitos, California. First down, Ducks. Option. Pitch. Poaching. Run out of bounds, and a penalty flag goes down.
5-yard face mask on the defense. Added to the end of the run.
Where both guys are putting their hands up in their faces. Cho Ching, he goes right to the face. 5-yard face. And the defender, that probably shouldn't be called either way.
The penalty makes it first and 4. Cho Ching still the tailback. He'll get the call. Slips the first tackle. Bangs to the 7-yard line. And another first down for the Ducks.
Real good patient. Watch how he sets up his blockers right here. Cuts inside there. And has that strength you talked about, all that bench press, what, 300 and some odd pounds bench pressing? This guy's only 18 years old.
345. He is Samoan. If you're wondering about the nationality on Ho Ching, I know we were when we came out. We've turned out some great football players from Southern California, some Samoans through the years. Swinging wide to the right, looking for daylight, looking for the end zone and a yard short.
Following his blockers and then having the strength to finish the play. Unfortunately, he's going to finish the next one on the sideline.
Drones is back.
Second down and goal. Oregon looking for his first rushing touchdown. And Achille had a wide open left. Didn't see him. And he's crushed at the 2-yard line.
Now, here's Nuamu right here. And as we let it roll, and you see all the action go to the left side of the screen. Brent, you could see it, but Achille's got a few other things on his mind, though. That's a long throw. But he's got the arm for it, doesn't he?
Sure. Now it's third down and goal. Here's Drones running for the corner, cut back, touchdown, first rushing touchdown of the day. 100-plus yards, a rushing touchdown, and a fiery pregame speech to go along with the earlier reception for the score. So two touchdowns on the day for Reuben Drones.
Michael Clues and Greg Payne out in front.
And for Michigan State, it's a nightmare in Eugene, Oregon, as the Ducks lead it 41-0. An angry Nick Saban moments ago. Unanswered points. Now remember, as Michigan State returns still another kickoff with Scott, that Oregon's defense gave up 29.2 a game last year. The Michigan State Spartans are looking for their first score. It is hard to believe, Dan, that this defense gave up better than 29 points a game, and they are shutting Michigan State out here today with 3:14 to go in the third. And around. Good play call that time for almost 10 yards with Herb Haygood from Sarasota, Florida, the redshirt freshman bringing it around.
This is a college group of kids, and let's try and get it simple and just let them fly around the field. Watch this block, though, by number 76 right there on Caleb Smith.
9-yard run, second and one. Burke fires left, got it for the first down, and Scott stops the clock as he steps out at the 48-yard line. First down and 10, near midfield. Scott goes in motion. There's swerving over to the 49-yard line. Picked up about 3. Second down and 6 with 2.5 minutes. Slot is off to the right. Pressure defense look, and then they back out with Sermon. Burke simply threw that one out of bounds. His wide receiver, Irvin, was sliding out to the flat.
From the right side here, you're going to see Fletcher. There he is as he comes on the blitz and then peels off and does a nice job of giving Burke absolutely nobody to throw the ball to.
Oregon giving Michigan State a lot of different looks right on the snap. They'll show one thing and back on out of it. Four-man rush, and Burke down fires over the middle. Grabbed by Oregon at the 25. And yes, it is. Interception. And it was picked off by Brandon McLemore, the junior.
This is Burke's second interception of the season. And he just lets this ball go a little bit too high. Pressure up the middle. And when you overthrow a guy that's 6'6", then you're really throwing it too high.
Off to the quarterback's right is the slot man. Drones' hole was jammed up. Good looking runner. Breaks free. 45, 50. Foot race. Drones goes. His third touchdown of the game. 75 yards.
In the first half, it was all the passing of Achille Smith. The Ducks are coming with the hammer now in the second half. And Reuben Drones couldn't have asked for a better first game at major college level.
He's already rushed for 197 yards. And he scored 3 touchdowns there. Remember the fiery speech he delivered at the very top of our broadcast. There are over 500 yards of total offense in this game. Diegas adds the extra point.
The blocking on the left side of the line. You see Aguirre, number 69, Weaver with a good turnout block. And then the fullback leads him up, but it's patience. Believing that those guys are going to get that block for you.
And then he pulls away from Michigan State's best tackler in the secondary, Sory Kanoe. When you look at Oregon's schedule, they have a real good shot at starting off this season pretty good. UTEP next week on the road. And then San Jose State, their Spartans. Welcome to Autzen Stadium.
Slips in the end zone. They let him out. They'd have buried him inside the 5-yard line. Fletcher was right there. That was Haygood who went down.
Well, the first three, of course, first two are non-conference. We don't see the Michigan State game up there, but the first three. But the real problem here is you've got Washington and Arizona State. But you get to SC. All these three are at home here at Autzen Stadium, where they are going to sell out every time. They got standing room only, and players are really rewarding this crowd.
First down, and Lloyd Clemens, the running back for the Spartans, with still a quarter to play. It's embarrassing for the Spartans, but this is.
Never want to say a team quit, but when you have a running play that goes right up the middle and the guy goes 75 yards on you, you may not have quit, but you certainly look discouraged.
They move the chains. Let's get on Jackaroo, Jack.
Hey, Dan and Brent, one of the things that the coaches talked to Rubens at halftime about was the fact that he was tending to dance through the holes. They advised him, said, look, show these guys your true speed. Show it north and south. He did on that run.
He sure did. First down and 10 for Burke and the Spartans. This is Haygood, number two, who steps in motion. Pounding right on back into what is a soft middle right now with Lloyd Clemens. I must tell you, the big question about this Oregon team coming into this game was the defense. And they have pitched a shutout so far. And they have stopped the Spartans on fourth down. They stopped them on third down. Two interceptions in the game. They've done everything.
And last year they gave up over 400 yards in total offense per game.
Showing pressure. Burke fires over Burris's head. Misread on that. Foster, very nice gentleman, an old timer, came back. And you know who went after him after Bellotti approached him when they heard he was going to come back? USC and Paul Hackett went after him. And only the relationship between Bellotti and Foster and the way you can live here in Eugene, Oregon, convinced him to come in here. And so be it. He did not go down to USC. They wanted him on their staff.
The fishing's a little better here in Oregon than it is in L.A. I understand.
It all depends on what you're fishing for, Mr. Fox. Second down and 10. Down, so here comes number 10. Now make it 0 for 10. 48 to nothing. Oregon over Michigan State. Well, the most yards ever allowed by a Michigan State defense was 666 against Nebraska back in 1995. Oregon with 514 today, leading by 48. And Michigan State putting the ball back to Fletcher. Big bounces and on into the end zone. One to the right hand side and smashes for a first down. And they got a huge new replay screen. Jackaroo, that is some picture up there, my friend.
And Brent, maybe that's why some of the people are staying right now, because behind me is a brand new $4 million supervision screen. And earlier today during the game, what did the fans get to see besides the replays? Well, how about the 60th home run of this season for Big Mac? They had it right here on the big screen. But here's the big problem, Brent. A lot of the people that were here before sitting were big fund givers, you know, alumni people. They moved them because they couldn't see the screen.
Can't blame them for that. Pay your money, you want to see the replay. First down, Ho-Chang. Another alley. Going to be a good one, it looks like, Dan. Going to be a real good one.
And going back to Jack's story about the $4 million scoreboard, 30 years ago or so, they built the stadium for $2.5 million.
Isn't that something? $2.5 to build it. Then, of course, they've added on, moved the press box over to the other side.
That's one of the finest replay boards I've seen in a stadium. The definition is outstanding on that board.
Worth every penny.
You gave much of it?
Every penny.
Phil Knight just
lots of pennies.
Money.
Yeah, you bet.
Do not think they saw Hill coming from behind with his arm draped all over Bobby Nero.
Yeah, number 15 and White got away with one. Here they are. It's a crossing route by Nero. Watch the left hand of Hill. And that brand new scoreboard.
That brand new
everybody
scoreboard.
Can see it.
Brings a double boom.
Oh
baby.
If you didn't have a sore back before that hit, you do now.
Hangs one beautifully. What a good looking putter.
Can they keep it out? No.
Down that inside the five. There's a young man with a Sunday future. We'll be right back. Well, the fire is complete. Out of bounds is Haygood. Dan, are the Spartans this bad? Or should I say, are the Ducks this good?
It may be a little bit of both, but they certainly have fallen well short of their offensive goals today. And it all adds up to not a goose egg on the board, but I'd call it a duck egg.
Second padded, seven. Burke in a foot race, throws against pressure, and completes one on the run to Haygood, who worked back across
the field. Quite a carryover from one year to the next.
Fadden blasts to the 41-yard line. Second and three. Put that flanker screen outside, and Haygood in a foot race crosses midfield. Burke to Haygood. 11:09 to go. First down there at the Ducks 37. Many backups for Oregon are on the field defensively right now. Burke fires high in the air. No, incomplete. So Nick Saban and offensive coordinator Gary Tranquil have coached together on four different teams. There they are. West Virginia, Navy, the Cleveland Browns, and Michigan State. But back in 82 at Navy, it was Tranquil who was the head coach and Saban who was the assistant. That's a migraine headache up there in that booth right now. Believe me. Second down and 10. They run it. Good call.
What Tranquil's looking for now is to just make a couple of positive plays. This has been a good drive for Michigan State. This is something that they can take away from this game. Maybe the only thing they can take away from this game offensively. But also they can say, hey, this is what it's supposed to be like, guys.
The crowd lusts for a shutout. I think we crossed wires just a little bit. I think he was talking to Mr. Jackson, and you might as well give Mark McGuire the play of the day. Why not? There's Burke, fires too high. Incomplete.
That time, that was a true freshman. Steve Smith working against the 6'6" Plaxico Burress, and very good cover.
There's another third down. 0-for-10, the Spartans.
They're going to run for it, and they are not. Turns it back. No.
This would, well, the place is rising right now. They're giving them a standing ovation before the play, and they'll stay up if they can stop that Spartans here. Clemens is the running back. Three wides for Michigan State. Looking for 3 yards. Burke is back, and he's got time. Middle, got it complete. To the 10, Burris out of bounds. First and goal for the Spartans.
Check out the pass protection here. It's just absolutely perfect. Oregon is nowhere near Burke. And that's a good pass. Very catchable ball for the tall kid.
Haygood's the slot man to the left. Burris alone to the right. Clemens the running back. Spartans searching for their first score. Burris one-on-one. Got it. Grabbed it. Touchdown, Michigan State. And it was a dandy reception.
This is a great catch. And he catches it with his hands. Fine throw by Burke with a lot on it. And the size of Burris, as he posts up the shorter joiner, gets him in the end zone.
Paul Ettinger pulled the extra point a little bit, but across it goes. My partner Dan Fouts, I guess, how long is it over to Sisters from here, my friend?
It's a two-hour drive dead east over the Cascade Mountains along the McKenzie River, over the mountains and through the woods.
Lovely, lovely country. How's your fires over there? We got some over in Montana. You got some over there at all?
Yeah, we had a little bit of problem whenever it gets this hot and this late in the season.
tough job out of the end zone, so it'll come out on the 20. Enrique.
Wearing number 7 looks a little bit like Scott Frost, didn't he?
That safety for the New York Jets, is that who you're talking about?
Yeah.
Scott Frost doing some special team work, back up Bill Parcells' defensive backfield. They get going against San Francisco, the 49ers, tomorrow. We'll see. Too much time as I look down and stuck on the clock. First down and 15 after the violation. You know, Oregon has hardly been penalized at all today, now that I think about it. Drones is out of bounds on the 18-yard line.
Jason Moss showed up at practice earlier this week with a blue cap with that familiar Maze M on the front. We said to him, said, you know, that's for Michigan, not Michigan State. He said, oh, I know, but, you know, we couldn't find a Michigan State cap out here. And then he said with a wink, besides, doesn't Michigan State get beat by Michigan all the time?
Frequently, indeed. And, you know, Jack, that man Drones that we've talked about, the JC running back, he's over 200 yards. They're putting it up on the big board right now. They're informing the crowd. Huge ovation. And Moss, he'll keep this one. First down on the run with 8:20 to go. Now I want you to watch this. Josh Bidwell punt this football. And the hang time that this young man gets on it. Throughout his career here, he has never, ever had a punt block. Now that's absolutely amazing. His average a year ago was just over 40 yards, and his net was 39, ladies and gentlemen. That is an unbelievable net off that average. And it's all because of the way he gets it up in the air and allows his coverage to form downfield. Side a little bit. Not one of his better ones. The coverage man gets picked off, and it's Scott. Scott breaks free. Scott still going inside the 40, as that time Bidwell did not get his customary hang time.
Dan, Ruben Drones showed us a little bit of everything today.
Well, he has power. He is very shifty, but I think the thing that the biggest question mark for the Oregon coaches is, what about breakaway speed? They weren't quite sure if he could run away from defenders. I think they're sure now.
Yeah, 202 yards, 3 touchdowns overall, 1 receiving, and that last touchdown was 75 yards. Ruben Drones. Was I premature when I said Akili was going to be the Chevy player of the game? We'll have to wait to see how my friends vote. Here comes Burke.
Deep down the left sideline, got one on one. No, deflected away from Haygood at the last instant. For a moment, it looked like he was going to make the reception. It hung in the air a little bit, and Steve Smith, the freshman corner, whacked it away.
And that's what defensive backs are taught, is when the receiver reaches for the ball, that's when you reach for the ball. Do not look back. If you look back, you're going to get beat. Look at that left hand come in. May have distracted Haygood. Haygood should have made this catch because it gets all the way to his chest.
Second down and 10. Would have been a toughie, but we've seen him made. Simmons pounds inside the 30-yard line.
One of the problems Oregon had last year, look at how far the defensive line is off the ball. That's 2 yards. And when you look at Oregon today, look how much closer they crowd the line of scrimmage. That's why they have turned things around with their run defense.
Simmons breaks free, 15, 10, headed in zone, got it, touchdown Michigan State.
Well, they're crowding the line too much this time as Clemens just rips into that secondary. But this is the type of play that Michigan State needs to finish off this game.
So Edinger, 5.5 minutes remaining here in Eugene, Oregon's opener. They're going to go 14-1 in their openers over the last 15 years. The only loss to Hawaii. And they're going to receive the ball here. Coming out from 6 yards is Parker. Short of the 20. Here's Parker. Hole jam. Slants out to the left. And then muscles his way out to the 28-yard line.
Today, all of the Oregon running backs, Drones, Parker, and Ho-Ching, have punished the Spartan tacklers.
For 571 total yards of offense, they have punished the Spartans here today. And on on second down. Parker adds a few more, swings it outside.
We told you a little bit about Nick Saban's philosophies. Mike Bellotti last year felt that his team maybe expected too much. They literally thought that they could have won 11 of their 12 games. So this year he switched to what he called his John Wooden philosophy. He preached to them the same things that Wooden told the UCLA basketball team for so many years. Hard work pays off. Take one game at a time. And this afternoon, before they came out, he said precisely that before he sent his charges out here. He said, guys, two things I want you to remember. Play hard and believe. So far they have.
I like a coach that lets us inside the locker room with the camera. That's a confident man. Man's got it going here in Eugene. Lovely part of the world in that Mashovsky Center off to my left-hand side over behind that big board that Jack showed you. I'm going to tell you, an indoor facility, the first of its kind in the Pac-10. That's going to help them recruit, going to help them get ready in the rainy season. Going to be great. Muscle short of the first down.
It really is, Brent, because the biggest knock on Oregon football has always been, well, you don't want to go to school there. It rains all the time. Well, they just got rid of that problem. They can practice indoors and not have to worry about the weather.
Also got some brew pubs in this town. Not too bad either, my friend. Five. Come to think of it, I can use a cool one when this one's over. Fire hard. And while I'm thinking about golf, Dan, you took me out to the Eugene Country Club. Thank you very much. And Oregon Athletic Director Bill Moose, formerly of Montana, enjoyed their hospitality. That is a wonderful old tree-lined track, just like you said.
And those greens are just a little quick, huh? Especially when you follow the mower around.
That guy, he delighted. What was his name? Scott.
Scott.
He saw you out there, and he just went and mowed every green before we showed up. Scott's going to make a tough catch. No, shouldn't have done that at all. Should have let that one hit.
Fair catch violation on the kicking team.
What I have seen twice, I'm not so sure about this one, but I saw it the other night on one of the games. There was a receiver, and he moved up, it seemed to me, into the area where a defender was. And I don't know, you know, how much leeway you've got, because clearly the man coming down at coverage, he's not looking at the football. You know, he's waiting to see who the man is. And if that return man jumps up on you into a spot, it seems to me like it's difficult for a coverage guy to, you know what I mean, to pull himself out of the way.
And it's difficult for the officials. It's one of those judgment calls. And whenever you have a gray matter type of call, it's not going to make anybody
most
happy.
Most of these numbers, Brent. In the first half, all four of those touchdowns came in the first half when he was absolutely brilliant. And highlighted by the throw to Nero in the back of the end zone when he was being hit and running to his left. He fired a strike on a line over the middle to a receiver wide open in the back of the end zone.
10 yards shy of 600 here today. Michigan will go home and play Syracuse. Lead over the middle. Stand cool. Looking like Lawrence of Eugene over there. Going down.
And there it is. You got to take your hat off, though, to Burke. He hasn't quit competing out
too long.
Not a bad way for Oregon's defense to start off the season. Three sacks in a row. And turn the ball over to their offense one more time before time runs out.
I got bad news for you, though. Oregon State's ahead 48 to nothing.
That's good news for all the folks here in the Great Northwest.
Absolutely.
Of course, they're playing
Nevada.
Nevada.
For Michigan State, Lloyd Clemens had a nice day running the ball. And, of course, Achilles Smith with those four touchdown passes. Remember, they scored the first six times they handled the ball against them. Two field goals and four touchdowns. And Achilles Smith with his career day, and he did it in the first half.
Well, Coach, you certainly wanted to make a statement. How about this one?
Well, I'm really pleased. I thought our kids were ready. I knew they were prepared. I wasn't sure if they were ready. They obviously were, and they exceeded my expectations. I'm really pleased. Offense, defense, and special teams, and I think we did make a statement today.
How about the play, first of all, of your quarterback? Incredible. And then at J.C. transfer running back.
Achilles Smith did exactly what we expected. I thought he would be a lot better this year. He's lived up to that. Reuben Drones, I told Reuben before the game he'll be the best running back on the field. I said they just don't know it yet. I think they do now.
Dan Fouts the greatest duck of them all, working alongside. And it was indeed a day to be thankful if you're an Oregon fan. They come away with a huge opening victory. Oregon starts on a huge note. I'm Brent Musburger saying so long, everybody. We hope you enjoyed Oregon's convincing win.